that on that. Nuts and bolts, you're gonna get reimbursed for my salary for another year.
Really?
That's what that number represents, 33.87, that's our three-year median level. Basically, what it's saying is the state is saying our value is gonna have to be reduced by 1.59%. That equal 33.33, it gets into that complication of why the state keeps saying it's gonna be at 33 and 33. These are pretty good median levels for three-year average, so.
Are there counties around that are so far out of whack that they're not getting that reimbursement?
Yeah. About seven in the state.
Some of those locally?
Had been, well, Calhoun County, Lasky, Hardin just now started getting it again. Just a few, like.
How does it feel?
It's important for, I think, it's not that hard. It's either you do it or the state will. So like Lasky County lost their reimbursement because their numbers were so far.
Out of whack.
Out of whack. And that's why the state will reassess in that county. And that's something I really feel like is coming to several counties that are part of Southern Illinois. So, that's why it's so important to reassess and stay on top of this stuff. So, this next one I'm gonna hand out is something I really don't enjoy talking about. But I think it's important to show you what trends are going on with property tax and kind of show you why sometimes it's very easy. It's not always easy to explain to people about tax rates. So if you guys are looking at this very first one, this is Joppa. This is in town. Of course, in 14, you see where their tax rate was at 10.8. 2015, it jumped to 10.9. And then in 2016, it jumped to 8.0, or dropped down to 8.9, and that was part of that settlement with the school district. But if you notice, then in 17, it dropped another 0.1, you know, 0.8, 0.08. 0.12. Anyway, if you look now at the dollars, how it went from 622 up to 627, down to 514, down to 507. You can kind of, when you kind of go through these, most of these, except for in town of Joppa, is going down this next year, which is encouraging, especially like in, you turn to the third page, Massac County. If you look, every year the tax bill went down for this parcel. And then look at the tax rate, how it went from 8.1 to 8.3, down to 7.75. That's why this stuff gets so challenging when people want to talk about rates, they want to talk about taxes, they want to talk about these different things. But ultimately, the trend's been, the property tax has been coming down, which I will tell you, most counties in the state of Illinois does not stand true. So that is, it is encouraging, but a lot of that is due to a lot of different things. One, levies, taxing districts, and PTEL, and your ability to get more money. Part of it's because the farmers are picking up a bigger share now. That trend's gonna continue. But the one thing I want to just kind of be a year out ahead, from what I understand, correct me if I'm wrong, Juanita, this settlement with LaFarge is done after this year, correct?
And actually, I'm not having to do anything with it, because when through PTEL, that goes through the treasurer's office.
That's a whole other thing.
Yeah, that's a whole other thing.
That's where I'm going with this, is because LaFarge challenged their value, that means that's gonna push that burden off to the rest of the taxpayers, and with this settlement coming off, these people's tax rates are gonna probably jump to.
Considerably.
Yes, to about 11%. That's just a preliminary guess, that's all I'm doing right now, but I just want people to know now, instead of a year from now screaming and hollering, they're being warned now that that rate is gonna jump substantially.
The people that are active in their tax bill down there know what's coming their way. The ones that are not active are the ones that's gonna be.
But I just want to put it out there now.
Dropped.
So that when it does happen, that everybody's prepared, and we're not gonna be, you know, going, I don't know. It's due to multiple things, and part of it was that little large reduction in value. That's taken off, that's gonna be taking some value down. So anyway, I just kinda wanted to give everybody a heads up on that. But anyway, I just thought it was interesting, and all I'm trying to do is just put some information out there as far as trends, and so everybody can see what's going on. It's kinda good news in my part. Especially like in the rural part of the county and in Metropolis. I mean, this one tax bill went down $110. I'm not used to seeing anything like that. I'm sure those people would appreciate. Of course, you're gonna have those people that we reassessed or they lost exemptions. Those people's tax bills, unfortunately, are gonna go up. But for the most part, I think you're gonna see these kind of trends happen. So Jason, that means your tax bill came down.
Hey,
just a tad bit. Well, don't thank me, thank the taxing district.
Yeah.
Because, you know, again, that I think that has a lot to do with it.
Good information, Gary.
Okay.
Appreciate it.
And anything else? By the way, my car doesn't have air conditioner.
No.
I got out there and just like to die. I know I'm not gonna do this. So.
Throw the 2 windows down.
No.
Drive
60.
255.
255 there. 2 windows down.
Yeah. So anyway, car's gonna be going in.
Perfect.
So.
What do you think it is?
I have no idea. I just probably Freon.
You did push the AC button, right?
Yes, I did push it.
Then you got the right keys.
And I got the right keys.
Yeah, the right key.
Yes.
That's
that always helps.
Yeah, that's great.
Yes, that's it happens. Right. Any questions, Gerald? You're studying that thing pretty hard.
Yeah. I know all these people here. I just wonder.
Well, we just pull random people.
Yeah. He just have to know everybody.
Well, of course, Gerald knows everybody. He's been here forever.
I know.
But like I said, for the most part, most of them are going to be pretty happy.
Yeah.
Like I said, for some reason, and again, if you look at the rates, that's encouraging.
Yeah.
But that's, because again, anytime your rate's under 8%, that's a good thing for the state.
I forgot to ask you about this. Are you interested?
Yes.
You are interested?
Yes. We get calls for the state's attorney on the time. And the treasurer.
We'll circle on it.
Fix it down for you.
Yes. Anything else?
No, I think so.
You have any questions or anything? Feel free to give me a call.
At least I haven't heard any different.
Yeah.
They asked me to ask them to do that brief. This year and going to construction about next April, along with some other repairs on the bridge, like up at Big Bay. And what was that?
Well, that should be like 6 months to a year of job.
I would think that the job itself would be at least 6 months.
Yeah, okay. Maybe less than a year, but I'll bet it'll be 6 months.
And to reconstruct all of that.
It'll be a chore. Or a landfill. Well, that whole new pile, the stand that the bridge is on.
Yeah.
Right.
two of them.
We bought two, that particular transmission side of town, we bought two. Or only chip, I mean, my plan is to maybe start a week at the 25th. Just make it up as well. Next week, then, put it out. Get ready to go, hopefully not throw it with any of them. Dirt dog and edge or something. Flat tires up in there.
I'm down the river, so it's my bike, so, been sitting there for a couple weeks. There was a bird nest blowed out of that stack, size of man's head.
Last week, we worked on power unit, we started it. Worked on one, the next afternoon started, it blew a bird nest out of the dog. One day, I don't know why there's a thick bit on the building.
I don't know.
All they do, they're all.
Yes, it's safe, you know.
Yeah, safe to a fire unit, blew it out. And they good one out there? All the Indians happy to drive?
Lightning hit the trees and went out 14 the last night.
It's storm?
It was pretty stormy out.
I heard it.
All be up?
Yep, very short lived.
Yeah. But that, it's, somebody's up.
Did it rain last week?
Yeah, and our house is doing rain a little bit.
We're midway, like an inch and a half.
Really? That's all in touch with that radio, no?
Yeah.
Some parts of the county didn't get it, so.
Yeah.
West, the northwest part of the county, I'll put it in.
I hope we go out there and put it, kind of irrigation off, but it's still running.
The dust.
Really, dust on one side, blood on the other, I think.
I don't really have anything else for you, it's been pretty awful.
Well.
So that manifests as success, I guess.
That's correct. How much is one cost?
A tractor. All I can tell you is the tractors we bought in 2006 cost about $90,000 a piece. That's what.
That's $90,000?
$95,000.
What's the number on the, you know?
I mean, the blow off from there.
Nothing cheap, does it?
Yeah.
These things, obviously have cats on it, and all that there.
Look up the file, that's what the file said, but surely that's not what for two.
No, it wouldn't be, it wouldn't be $45,000, it'd be like me that.
No, is that a special factor? You might have to have a tractor.
I think it's a tractor, a wagon tractor, it looks like.
I didn't see a special one, it's not.
But would you use the old, the rest of it good?
Well, yeah, it's about, transmission could really work till then, all the time. A lot of times, the boys can start up, give them backup, there's a couple there, beat before the week, so it's going to fall. So if there was been problems with it for a while, it just decided to really crap out. But as far as any more snow, I guess, everything else on it, or it's okay.
Pete Gill still around?
Gill, right.
Eric.
Move.
So a guy could get it for fire, you know?
Yep.
Pete Gill quit. Good to know.
Yep.
Will it be on auction?
Well, I'm hoping it's transmitted.
Hopefully.
I don't really want to spend $90,000.
That you ain't got.
I'd rather put that for the big up front. If they get the other one, it's nice to get out of their car.
I heard from the insurance company that the cost would be up to $2,500. And it's going to cost another $2,500 to fix it, so $5,000 fix. But I don't think we've heard that. Tried to call the adjuster and run around to two or three people. They don't know. Trying to figure out how to get back here, throw it back or call it back or expect us to go do it, yeah. Yeah, but it's in Effingham and has to go to Quincy or where?
No, it's going to be done.
The final.
You saying it'll be done ready for the road?
Haul it back there, right?
Yeah, but I'm
getting it driving negative.
If the insurance covered hauling it up there, I was wondering if the insurance
should
ever bring it back.
It should have.
If you send a guy up there, I mean, that's an overtime day, probably.
Yeah.
Three plus hours driving from the haul.
Take off at 7 and get back by 5, let's say.
No, he said there's all over the road.
Did fall out some back, somebody take that.
There's no bucket back. But there's all over.
That's getting worse.
So,
It's called heat, isn't it?
Well, I went down there and you turn off there, go on the hill and that was perfect.
On the other road.
Turn off the red thing.
Yeah. In front of that guy's candy shop there. It was down on the left. It was just hot. All of it.
Suffering now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just that people were going around with it. So bad, but I'm saying, hold on. And the man's spread. Right, I've got a bunch of stuff down there. I've got a little bit of chips on there.
Chips don't work too well. When that happens in the heat of the summer, a lot of times it's lines.
That's what I'm saying. The guy really needs a line spreader. Just run over there and fan it out.
It is.
I mean, if I were to lay,
know, if we get out that way or different, it's that way.
Yeah, you chip it in a little bit.
Yeah. Using our neck, there's an access on the road, we need to apply, but it's going to be quite a bit.
It beats dirt road.
I was gonna ask something, Ken Kovak was in here last week, and he had, you know, got an idea of maybe having one number, lead number for the courthouse, for all things, then have an extension. If you go around there as well, the highway department, take your current number from 524-5227, would you be interested in that, or not? If you would just have a lead number here.
That's from here last week, and then that's from Missouri, or do you have?
Extensions, let's say, just mention that extension, that would go directly to you, or are you interested in that, or not? Some of the offices here, I guess, get phone calls all the time, like county clerk, and I said they're trying to reach a certain clerk or vice versa.
We don't have, we didn't take call.
Okay.
The high school phone, okay, her, front to your phone, sorry. We have to switch services, I'm not sure if we're getting to that.
Okay.
Because I know that.
Put you down.
Fire department, when they had BJK internet out there, it was, they had problems like, dozens of times a year with squirrels chewing through it, and they were out of service.
Yeah.
They found all the time.
Yeah. So, I don't know, I mean, if they could incorporate it with our current service, I would pay. I really wouldn't care if our service was out for a long time.
That's the way we feel. One-way service, all out.
I mean, that'd be kind of nice, actually.
Some days, but.
Maybe I do want to switch, Jason.
Well, the reason why he came up with this, because he was in my office for about 30 minutes one day, every phone call we got in that 30 minutes was for circuit court. Every phone call.
You know what, and the tickets, if somebody gets a speed ticket or wherever it says on there, call the county, the circuit clerk.
But see, Google's got our number wrong.
Oh.
So if they Google it, they're gonna get me anyway.
I get a call about 4 times a week from these people that want to update my Google, I'll just give them the picture instead.
Well, I have tried, me and John both tried for years, and they will not fix it.
Google has, on the internet, said that the Memorial Gardens phone number is our phone number.
Oh.
So, we get a dozen calls a month about wanting somebody, marry somebody.
Yeah. Well, we can do it. We can send a backhoe out there.
Extra revenue for the county on the side.
All right, well, I'm out here.
You get my son, y'all.
Thanks.
Yes, I got the answer about the question.
Okay.
Judy, mine.
Pull it off. Oh, well, so now if we need to pull out the house and everything.
The one we're going to have there, then, yeah, city's on it.
Well, it needs it. Has nobody stole the liquor coolers and stuff out there yet?
The central end still.
That's what, yeah, why the heck can't you take out that plane? These tents are like cleaned up and ready. You be independent.
The stairs, it is falling.
Yeah.
But you know, the house ain't gone. Now, I did talk to the guy, said he had a partial baseline, I didn't know that. I didn't say anything, so long. Yes, it does.
That 611 girl makes it.
I We can do a little bit.
Included the half of the car.
Okay. So it's like $7,000.
So I figured we got 97, probably about $50,000 in bills.
But in next week's payroll, really?
Yes. And we haven't got like local use tax. People get personal property again until the first of July. We still got several things out, so the reimbursements.
You heard me talk about the phone, are you all interested in that, that they have?
Or regular, could you still call our number direct?
I don't know.
No, it could be, they'll get that one number.
You get that one number, then it'd be an extension of say, like, for instance, yours was 1212. The direct number's 5121, right?
The Pulaski County Courthouse has already done it, have you done it?
I don't know.
Jackson County.
Probably give us phone bills.
The temporary air that's coming in Thursday. Will there be some in the small courtroom, or will that air conditioner still be hooked up, or?
That will still be functional.
Okay.
Yeah.
The auditors from Schroeder, Smith Row, and all that are here.
Are they using the small courtroom?
They are this week, and then they said it'd probably be about 4 weeks before they came back, so.
Today we're opening most bids at 11, so are they gonna be in there today? We can move it to another room, so. Is that, that stuff still set up in the other room, or did they?
Well, they came and got the chairs, the Superman celebration thing that they did, but the table's still there, and the chairs are still around.
Okay. I'll have to find out when he's working on that.
Okay. Yeah, I told you wrong on that. I said, well, then we could circulate that notice back, and evidently the judge.
So I don't know if he's or not. He said, well, you need to get that done. I said, well, and for, I didn't know how to write that.
Yeah, I think that's where the signals got crossed and talked to Judge Weeks and about that notice.
Does he know that yet, or?
Judge Weeks.
It's up to his, it's up to him, but.
We haven't had any conversations with him that I know of, so.
I'm finding out where he's working. I was telling him that, you know, he does hiring anyway, doesn't he?
He makes the appointment, yeah.
So.
Yeah, we appropriate the money and make the judge then appoints who he wants for the position.
Yeah.
Is your office cool there, Aaron?
Our office has been fine. It got, I don't know if I told you, it got hot in the.
Yeah, I got a cold Saturday around noon or 1 o'clock or something like that.
Foyer area up front, it got pretty hot.
I think. Is it better now? I mean, I just wondered if it was just the door opening and all the traffic.
Yeah, I mean, that didn't help. I don't have all the people in the door open as much as it was. And so I'm sure that was a major part of it. Just couldn't keep up. I haven't noticed it today that it's hot walking through there.
When I was up there, there was a ton of people in there, so.
It's a big crowd.
You know, they're, just their bodies, heat the damn sun.
Yeah.
Are y'all about ready to go over there?
He's about to go over there.
Is that a motion to adjourn?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine. Switch. So right now, we just have one.
Okay.
Hoping for more.
It's not quite 11 yet.
Yeah, it's not.
10:59 by my phone.
We'll see. I, you know, had a few people call me Friday. Did they say anything?
They were just asking some questions. I told them to refer them to you.
Yeah.
And to particular blueprint.
Okay.
I had a lady with some type of union association.
I mean, the only questions I got was from the emails I forwarded to you.
Yeah.
Hmm.
leave this morning.
6:30. I didn't get any sleep last night. I don't know how I moved to get up. I closed my eyes there for a second and I'm in the middle of the road. I was like, oh my God, she had a question.
Yeah, she was funny, you know. Some questions about the blueprints over there, the big blueprint. She wanted the permission to get it. I'll get you into the proper channel.
Okay. Sometimes contractors, they'll contact the architect and like, can you send them the prints?
She tried to call you yesterday. Sarah, I don't know if you got a voicemail. I gave her your email address.
I didn't get it.
You ready?
Yeah, okay. I guess.
So one of these, the same bid is just multiple copies?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
No bid file.
So this here looks like a bid submitted on 6/11/2018 from Everett String Construction out of 17, or out of Marion, Illinois. Looks like the bid is for $1,695,000. Unit price, plaster, wall, patch, $68 per square foot.
There's two unit prices on there. There's the unit price, and then there's the unit price that was on the form as well.
Okay. Provide the unit price for removal of water damage, installation, and install a new roof insulation. Match existing thickness, $25 per square foot.
Mm-hmm. And then there's the unit price for the patch plaster wall.
$68 mm-hmm. per square foot.
Okay.
And then there was alternates, I guess for alternate A, it was just zero, is that right?
Yes, sir.
Alternate B, there's another copy. Alternate B, or the steam boiler removal, add $7,505. For alternate 3, service and maintain agreement, add $66,000. Alternate 4, electrical panel replacement, add $2,859. And alternate 5, vestibule door replacement, add $13,000.
So you and I need to talk after this.
Well, yeah, the commissioners, yeah. I mean, yeah. Ultimately, we're going to make a decision today on this.
Yeah. Thanks for showing up, guys.
No problem.
Thank you.
Thanks,
guys. Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Be careful.
Take care.
Oh.
I think a big part of it is they picked up the plans late.
Other contractors.
Because I got two emails in the last week asking to push the bid date. And we decided to keep this date because they had 4 weeks prior to the 3.5 weeks prior to the pre-bid and then another week afterwards. So they had 4.5 weeks to get the plans, which is for project size, there's no reason why they couldn't get a price together. They typically wait till the pre-bid to pick up the plans. And then, so they basically had a week to turn around the price. Sometimes they can't get that. I guess for them, they couldn't get that done. until price is too high. And I think maybe an option would be, and this is up to you, is pull the project and then try to value engineer it and then rebid it. I mean, I can talk to Eric and see what he has to say, but.
What are you talking about?
Well, value engineering is basically we will go back to the drawing board and see what we can eliminate from the project to get the price down. Because I know we were talking about the 1.3 area, $1.3 million,
yeah,
somewhere there. And it's obviously significantly higher than that.
And, you know, maybe we should also broaden our range of who we contact to try to get people interested. Like, I contacted the data center in Silver Illinois, dropped this plan, and maybe we need to go out a little bit further and talk to the union halls and the different people to get more people involved.
Yeah.
Okay.
So. Yeah. I'll talk to Eric. I'll talk to our engineers. See what they have to say, and then we should probably have a conference call sometime later this week.
Okay.
Talk about it and see what our options are.
Do we want to get back to some of those people that weren't interested, or was that the pre-bid meeting? Email them and say, what was your concerns?
Yeah, I think that would probably be a good idea, is follow up with those contractors, see why they weren't interested, see what hesitations they had, some, maybe address some of their concerns.
Okay. Got any thoughts on it?
Lots of dollars.
Yeah.
Just a total elimination, I don't know what it would be.
What do you mean?
Eliminate some stuff that we're doing.
Yeah, and I mean, but majority of the work is mechanical work, so I couldn't tell you what they could eliminate. I'm sure there's some systems they can fine-tune, or maybe they can look at some alternate systems, see if they can get some money out that way. But because they're not here, I can't really communicate intelligently and tell you why or what we can eliminate. Get the money out.
What do you think, Josh? Any ideas?
No, I mean that'd be kind of up to you guys of what you can do there to refigure it. Obviously, the more bids, the more competition we have, the more we get the price down. I guess one concern we're gonna have is they're moving forward on the windows. We're gonna seal this building up pretty well. Mm-hmm. Pretty soon, you know, and now we're looking at probably delaying this for a period of time.
In which we have Tim Baird coming in Thursday to install those temporary units in each of the offices. And
that's going to get pretty expensive too.
Yeah, it runs close to $4,000 a month.
Yeah.
So we need to get going on that. That's why you don't get going.
Well, let me, like I said, let me talk to Eric, see how quickly we can turn around.
Okay.
The engineers as well.
Plus we're running two buildings, you know, lower.
Right.
Yeah, lower.
That's expense too. So the longer we wait, but
the higher it goes.
Higher it goes, you're right.
Well, ideally, you guys could probably eliminate the AC units or the temp air, like probably September or October.
You mean when temperature's cool?
Yeah.
I don't know, but yeah, it's a possibility. I did have one contractor contact me, and he said he was just wanted to know if he could wait and start something like in the fall with this. I said, well, you know, this will be down by December 1st. You know, they were just covered up with other projects right now.
And that's, part of that is also everyone's busy. That's, I mean, everyone's got work right now. Everyone's got a project. They can pick and choose what they work on, unfortunately. This was 2009, 2010. You have a line out before. Sorry, guys. back to the drawing board a little bit. Just step back. It's not. We'll figure it out.
Okay. Without any, that will just pay the difference.
Would be about $395,000.
Yeah, that's what you get for right? Just shy of $400,000.
I can't afford that. I would have to work a couple of years at least, a couple, maybe 10. Let me hold on to that, and I'll send you an email tonight, and we'll schedule a conference call.
And I'll keep them communicated.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Thanks, guys. Boys, I'm going to work.